Be ready, start. Trade union are an essential feature of the modern industrial civilization. So pervasive is their influence that it has penetrated even to such untrade-like activities as teaching. Voluntary organizations of workers, such unions were initially formed to promote and protect their basic interest. And in the early stages of their growth, they did play significant role in bringing about unity and solidarity among workers and in saving them for exploitation at the hands of their employees by organizing systematic and effective resistance. But it is a sad commentary on the decline and deterioration of moral climate in the country that even they have become tools of personal aggrandizement in the hands of power hungry instead of securing the interest of workers. They often expose them to undesirable and utterly unnecessary hardships. Para, the All India Trade Union was set up in 1920 to bring about cohesion among the various labor organizations and to extend the movement all over the country. The formation of the All India Trade Union gave a great fillip to the rapid formation of union throughout the country, and their number as well as membership rapidly multiplied. Para, the union have been concentrating all their efforts on organizing strikes as if they exercise solely for this purpose. They have never thought it fell within their structural purview to undertake beneficial activities like the provision of medical relief and organization of education and cultural activities. Finally, the illiteracy and ignorance of their workers, their migratory character, their diverse cultural origins, their low wages and low capacity to pay subscription have also led to the inefficiency of the trade union. If trade union movement in this country has to be made an effective instrument in the promotion of workers' interest, it needs some radical structural changes. It may be difficult to amalgamate different warming functions into a coherent and purposeful organization, but unless it is achieved, the unions cannot serve any useful purpose. It is high time the trade unions realized that they owned their basic duty of the workers and not to the political parties to which they are invariably affiliated. This could be facilitated if the leadership passed into the hands of workers themselves. In the early stages of the movement, when the workers were utterly unorganized, external leadership was not only helpful but even necessary. But now the trade unions are taken over by the workers. Be ready, start.